In this video brought to you by Kittle, I'm going to be showing you the easiest but most effective and cool brand assets or graphic design assets you can create in just a couple of minutes inside of Adobe Illustrator. Hi, I'm Will. I'm a graphic designer and I own a design agency in the north of England. And this channel is all about teaching you how to get better in your creative journey through graphic design and logo design. So you may think it takes a lot of knowledge. It doesn't really. It only takes two shapes. What we're going to do first of all is we're going to create an O, just like that. Keep it as perfect as you want. We're going to get rid of the fill because we don't need that. So go ahead, select this circle or any shape, go to effect, down to distort and transform, and we're going to go to we're going to zigzag. Press relative and smooth first of all, and we're going to just bring this down quite a bit. We only want a little bit of like these zigzags here. Press OK. Now, if you want to change this effect, you can go ahead and go to window and then go down to appearance, and it'll pop up with this little panel where you can change the effect. You can turn it off and on as well. What I'm going to do is go ahead and duplicate this by holding option drag, and we're going to go to another effect. We're going to go to effect, down to warp, and we're going to just choose one of these effects over here. Let's choose wave, and we're going to just bring that into the middle a little bit, and we're just going to change it ever so slightly like this. You can see I'm not doing very much. This is just warping it essentially. And then I'm going to go ahead and make a copy of these and just drag these down a little bit, because we need to expand these first. By expanding, it means to take the effect and put it into effect, so it's not just this layer on top. You can see this blue line on the outside. That signifies that the actual shape hasn't changed. It's just an effect, so it's an illusion. So when we go ahead and select both of these, go to object and expand appearance, you'll see that it changes into the actual effect. The blue line is within the effect itself. Now we're going to go to object, and we're going to go down to blend this time and go to blending options. We're going to go to specified steps and press 20. So anywhere between 10 and 20 works well. Press OK. Now select both of your shapes, go to object again, go to blend, and then press make, or you can press command option or alt B. We have this weird effect going on here. You can see it looks pretty decent. Now what we can do is mess around with it even more. So we can select this, go ahead, go to warp, go to shell or any of these other ones like fish, press OK, and boom, we have our cool effect already there. Pretty easy. You can even do this with multiple different kinds of shapes. For instance, if I'm here, I can drag this anywhere to here. Maybe just bring it up slightly like so. Select these two, blend them together, and we get this really cool effect going on here where it looks 3D. And again, we can go ahead and apply shell or any other effect to this as well, and it will make it even more trippy. Now, to be able to use this properly, you can go ahead and expand it again very easily. Just going to object and expand appearance, and boom, we've got a stroke that we can change the color off, scalable, and it works. Now, let's say you wanted to go for a bit more of an anti-design approach. Well, there are plenty of ways you can do this. It doesn't have to be just with shapes. It can be with letter forms as well. But what if we wanted to go a bit different and not just 2D, even though this has got like elements of 3D in it? Well, before I show you, I want to thank the sponsor of this video, Kittle. Kittle is an online web app built to make complex design easy. If you've ever seen vintage or retro designers and they spend ages like handcrafting these things out, or in Illustrator trying to find the right font, well, Kittle does it for you online with a web app. It's super simple. So if you're new to graphic design, this is an amazing app to get some cool looking designs on there straight away if you don't know how to use Illustrator very well. They've got loads of fonts. It's preloaded. They've got illustrations that are pre-made. It's literally as easy as you're watching right now. And you don't need expensive software to run these. It's very simple. Now, if you click the link down in the description or in the pinned comment, you get 3 months completely free of the pro subscription, which allows you to do all this. So if you're new to graphic design, or if you just want to get your hands in on some amazing vintage and ornate design, then go ahead, go and try it. and tweet at me the designs that you create so I can critique them as well. Now let's say we want to do something a bit different with this. Well, let's go ahead and select it, and we're going to go to Effect again, but we're going to go to 3D. We're going to go to Extrude and Bevel. Now this is a new feature inside of Adobe Illustrator. Instantly we can see something a bit different here. It is actually 3D and we can move this around. So we've instantly created something really strange already, and you've got this 3D panel as well. This 3D panel allows you to change the lighting so you can diffuse it, add some intensity to the light. Obviously the ability to like warp this around and move it in 3D space as well. This looks insanely fun and it's really cool to have for like posters creating 3D elements really quick. You can see there how trippy it looks, and you can do this for all the shapes as well. So take this one, we'll go ahead and expand it. Let's make it into 3D by extruding it, change the color, boom. We can change the depth and map it around. So instantly we've got some graphic design elements that you can use in posters or any work that you see fit. Now the next way of doing it is really interesting and simple. And my friend Jim over there, another graphic designer that works with us, actually showed me how to do this, and it's really simple, but it looks way complicated. All we need to do is draw a shape. So let's draw a circle. Let's mess around with this circle a little bit. We can use a warp feature actually. Let's do that. Let's warp this just a little bit. Let's expand it. We're going to go to Effect again. We're going to go to 3D and Materials, but go down to Classic this time and go to Revolve. You'll see this weird like donut pop up, but what we want to do is go to wireframe in the surface, and we can create this really cool donut shape. You can do this for a lot of different shapes and get some cool things out of them. For instance, let's just do this, create a square sort of shape going on here. I don't know, something like that. And we've got these really cool shapes going on here as well, but it's a wireframe, which is really interesting. It shows you the 3D wireframe of it, makes it look like a hologram. Now there are so many more assets that you can create inside of this. It's actually insane. And what they do is they help spice up your work. Now, the only thing is it can take time to create these. So when you're creating for a client or even for your portfolio and you need some inspiration or you just want to use some assets easily, drag and drop. We have got you covered for that because we created a new website called Assets 4D, which is all about assets for you, like designers. And also it's about creating assets that are out of this world, helpful for a good price. One of our first products that we're bringing out is the Vector Pack, which is literally tons of assets inside of Illustrator, Procreate brushes, and in different file types for you. These are just some of the assets that you'll be getting, which are really fun and interesting. You can drag and drop them into poster designs. You can drag and drop them into client work, into your portfolio. Saves you time, really easy for a great price. We created this website so you guys could have even more assets. Click the link down below again if you want to check out that new website. It's new and it's interesting and you'll like it. So there you go. Those are some ways to create some assets and to get assets that help you in your design work, sell your design work, and to look even better and to save you a lot of time. If you enjoyed this video and you think a friend should listen to it, maybe you've got a designer friend, go ahead and send them the link or share this on Facebook or Twitter, wherever you're at. If you're new around here, thanks for watching. Really appreciate it. If you press that red subscribe button, I will love you forever. And that is a promise. Again, leave your questions down below in the comments. I'll be reading them and I'll see you guys in the next video. See you soon. Goodbye.